I don't know. I'm not attached to that corner.
Okay.
Anyways.
Bueno, mi esposo, Ángel, se vino primero de mojado.
He went back.
Porque estábamos muy amolados de primero. Se vino indocumentado. Después empezó a hacerse mejor las cosas. Y se fue a vivir al Paso, Texas. Mm-hmm. O sea que nosotros nunca pasamos de mojado.
They were never at first.
Just y este... Y ahí estuvimos en Ciudad Juárez como más de un año hasta que me arreglaron los papeles.
Where we first landed, when we first drove through the desert and on the way to Los Angeles. Mm-hmm. We ended up at Winchell's Donuts in East LA. Mm-hmm. I remember like it was yesterday. Yeah. I remember my dad picked up his car. We had a station wagon. He put flat boards, you know, 2x4s, so that everybody had a bed. Like we were stacked like sandwiches in the back.
Yeah.
And then came in handy because I don't know why my dad did some dumb bone ass things. He decided to go across the desert and take a shortcut. So he's driving through the desert and his tires got stuck. So he was able to use the planks that he had to dig himself out of that mess. Yeah, we first lived on East Graves and then we ended up living on West Graves on the other side. Mm-hmm.
In 1976.
Yeah, so the year that your mother was born, actually you bought the house. Because what? We brought her here when she was newborn.
¿Cuánto ha cambiado la vecindad desde?
¿Cuánto ha cambiado la vecindad desde que te cambié?
Uy, muchísimo.
A lot.
The bridge used to be really narrow, and you used to have to go. Like that street where Ponce's is, right there, that's closed off. It's just a parking lot.
Yeah.
You'd have to go down this really, really narrow street to kind of get like this really weird turn onto the 15. And the 15 didn't go all the way through. You drive the 15, and it would turn into 40th Street, and you would drive 40th Street, and then it would turn back into the 15 again.
Oh, that was his favorite market.
I know.
He used to get all his little produce there.
He's so funny.
Yeah.
That was a favorite spot for him. He was devastated when he heard him close. He was a walker. He walked everywhere. He loved to walk. So he would walk from here down Mountain View to our house on Holly. That's where we used to live before he died. And he would get pulled over by the cops because of his appearance.
They thought he was homeless.
He wasn't much of a dresser. So he wore black and he always had a jacket on and he had
backpack.
Yeah. So very enraged over his experiences that he used to tell me about, and I wanted to felt like I had to come up swinging, you know. So we'd have a talk and I'd tell him, well, you tell him this and you tell him that, nah, I'd say I'll take care of it.
I'm born.
Well, Mom was born almost exactly a year after we got married. We got married on August 30th. She was born August 14th. It was a good time to move. I think I quit my job and just decided I wanted to be closer to my mother. So
Grandma was still in this house?
She was here. Yeah. And we got an apartment right down the street, off of 38th Street.
Where Jack's old school, normal high.
Oh, yeah.
Right there.
Yeah.
Bell, when I got into junior high, I think Bell was also in a bad neighborhood. And that one too was like a, then I started to feel like there were more Mexican kids in that school. You did more classes in English well, it was all English now, and I only took one French class. But it was weird in that I had chicks that I would find out that didn't like me.
Mm-hmm.
Because I wasn't Mexican enough for them, or, you know, I didn't talk like a little chola, and I didn't speak very good Spanish.
Yeah.
And that kind of carried all the way through high school, because, you know, I ended up in, like, magnet and gate classes. And then it always made me feel like I somehow was lacking in both areas, you know. I wasn't a good enough Mexican, and I wasn't white like these other girls, so where did that put me?
I always felt like I was straddling both sides of the fence. I was, you know, I wasn't good enough to be completely Mexican, and I wasn't completely Mexican, but I also wasn't pocha. I wasn't, you know, didn't know enough English, and I didn't have enough white friends and so forth to feel part of their culture. So I always felt like I didn't belong.
We were not stereotypical Mexicans. My mom doesn't have an accent. I never had an accent. And to see people that you love, or the way people would treat my grandmother because she didn't speak any English, you would get enraged over those ideas because...
Yeah, like they would touch my mother and like raise her voice because they thought she couldn't hear.
Huh.
You know, she couldn't hear just well. She can't hear nothing now. But before, when she used to be able to hear, you know, they would raise her voice instead of talking to her slowly, so that she could understand.
I think that I have, I kind of look at it in a different way. I have a great amount of pride in where my family came from. I guess I have a great amount of pride in my family and where our roots are. An identity for loving the beautiful things that have come out of, you know, the art and the culture and the food is the best food in the world. And, you know, the pride that we have in our family traditions that come from that country.
Estamos ver un poco el cuadro ese.
Oh,
next question.
Te digo, bro.